coming off two impressive tournament wins in Dubai at Glory 20, here comes Simon Marcus.
Simon Bad Boy Marcus, representing Canada, making his way to the glory ring for the fourth time, coming off a victory in the middleweight contender tournament at Glory 20 Dubai in April, beating Wayne Barrett and Jason Wellness in back-to-back fights to secure his title shot. He did his training camp in Thailand for that tournament with former K-Max champion, K-1 Max champion, Buakaw Porpramik, now Buakaw Banchamek, who made the transition from Muay Thai to kickboxing better than anyone.
And the training with Buakaw was instrumental in him because it changed his whole attitude toward kickboxing.
Marcus, you protect yourself at all times, you understand me? Obey my commands at all times, especially when I say stop and break, okay? I will give...
He has proven himself time and time again as one of the best pound-for-pound strikers on the planet, Artem Levin!
Raucous reception from the partisan crowd as Artem the Lion 11, now fighting out of San Diego by way of Siberia.
Man's got rhythm. He's so relaxed.
Number one in the world in kickboxing, one of the pound-for-pound best strikers on the planet. Grew up idolizing Roy Jones Jr. and Muhammad Ali. And it was in this very venue, Stephen Quadros, back in 1973, that Ken Norton handed the greatest of all time, Ali, his second professional loss via split decision. In fact, I thought Norton beat Ali all three times, but we are set now for the main event. Let's go to the numbers.
Artem Levin is 2 inches taller, but Simon Marcus has a winner's reach advantage. Big deal. The numbers don't tell the story. Their styles do, because the clinches are gone, so you can forget that. Levin will have the advantage and the gift of movement.
When it comes to kickboxing, it does not get any bigger than this. The Glory Middleweight Championship on the line. The champion defending the title against the number one contender.
We are live inside the Valley View Casino Center in San Diego, California, for your main event of the evening. Five rounds for the Glory Middleweight Championship of the World. It's about sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission. Their executive officer is Andy Foster. Their chairman, John Carvelli. From sunny San Diego to kickboxing fans watching in over 160 countries around the world, it's time for Glory! Introducing first, standing on my left and fighting out of the black corner, the challenger. He is a WBC Muay Thai champion, a kickboxing world champion. His record, 42 wins, two losses, and one bout scored even, 24 of those wins coming by way of knockout. At 6 feet, 1 inch tall, 1.85 meters, he weighed in at 184.5 pounds, 83.7 kilos. He fights tonight out of Toronto, Canada. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Simon Bad Boy Marcus. Here now is his opponent, fighting out of the white corner, a two-time European and world champion. His professional record, 50 wins with 4 losses and 1 draw. 33 of those wins have come by knockout. At 6 feet, 3 inches tall, 1.90 meters, he weighed in at an even 186 pounds, 84.3 kilos. He fights tonight out of San Diego, California, by way of Siberia. Ladies and gentlemen, the reigning and defending glory middleweight champion of the world, Artem the Lion Levin. Your referee in charge of this contest is Marcos Rosales.
Veteran referee Marcos Rosales has been assigned by the California State Athletic Commission to preside over this glory middleweight championship bout. Artem the Lion Levin, 6-1 in glory, 54-1 with 33 knockouts in Muay Thai and kickboxing. Marcos, 2-1 in glory, 42-2-1 with 24 KOs in Muay Thai and kickboxing.
This is for the glory middleweight championship of the world. Touch him up, obey my commands at all times.
It's the rematch we've all been waiting for, this time under glory kickboxing rules. Bad boy Simon Marcos, glory middleweight champion Artem the Lion Levin.
Fight!
The bell in round one, scheduled for 5 3-minute rounds. Mauro Ranallo, the fight professor, Stephen Quadros at ringside. The champion in the white gloves, Marcos in the black. Check that kick. You're going to see world-class technique on display here tonight.
Both these guys are explosive right now.
Stop, break clean.
And the clinch
those elbows going
will
in.
Be a factor again. Go. Under glory rules, it must be an active clinch. You have 5 seconds to initiate a knee attack. Oh, vicious left hook right above the belt line by Levin.
Those kind of punches are definitely going to be a factor.
Go!
Levin's so relaxed, so angular with his boxing, but he's initiating the clinch here.
He is initiating the clinch.
Go!
And if you do that, you must throw a knee. There's a stiff jab connects by Marcos, and already the clinch being a big-time factor in this fight, and it will be incumbent upon Marcos Rosales to ensure that they continue to do what Marcos just did there, delivering that knee. And as you so astutely put it before the fight started tonight, you said in the clinch the knee is more like a jab.
Yeah, well, unless you bring it straight up the middle, because if you do a body lock clinch, you can only slap with the knees.
Spinning back fist blocked.
Stop! Get out! Get out!
Knees by Levin.
Go!
Coming up on the midpoint of the first round.
You're wrestling, guys. You're wrestling. You're gonna go. Let's go.
There's a lead left hook to the body by Marcos. Jab pops his head back, delivered by the champion.
There's one thing about Marcos, he's got a lot of power in those punches. He usually throws everything with power, and sometimes that causes him to get tired, but he really learned a lesson from Buakaw that last time they trained in
Thailand. Couple of left hooks to the body by Levin, spinning back fist. Marcos blocked it, coming forward. A minute remaining in the first round. Marcos stands 6-1, the champion, Levin at 6-3. Levin able to duck away or back away from the left hook, counters with the jab.
All right. All right, both you guys are holding.
It's crazy how Levin.
Yes, and there's Rosales finally warning them. They are holding way too much.
Yeah.
Levin, a consummate counterpuncher, a la Floyd Money Mayweather, and Levin, of course, considered one of the, if not the best pound-for-pound fighter on the planet right now, as Marcos clinches again. Levin delivers a knee, they exchange knees, and
it's almost like they want to fight a Muay Thai fight, they don't want to fight a kickboxing fight.
Yeah, Marcos Rosales may need a throat lozenge before this is done.
Break clean. Go! Time!
Wow, interesting.
So, Stephen, unofficially, a lot of clinch work. Each of them had their brief moments of success. How did you score the opening round?
There wasn't a lot of damage done by either guy, but I would have to say Artem Levin, with a couple of his good body shots, barely squeaked that round out. I don't like draw rounds, but that was the closest thing to a draw round that I've seen in a while. So I would have to say that Artem Levin got it, because he was more aggressive and he dictated some of the element, but he was dictating the clinch. That's the thing that was baffling me. I thought he wanted to stay out of the clinch because he lost the last time in the clinch.
Right.
I mean, but the thing is, it was a really close fight. Could have gone either way, to be honest, that last fight.
Comes from a hard mining town in the Kuzbass region of Siberia, Russia's main coal producing area.
Take it down, my piece is in!
The lovely Alyssa. You can follow her and Atiya, the Glory Girls, on Twitter. Social media very active tonight. Everyone enjoying Glory 21, including a lot of new fans. And we hope you will continue to support one of the most exciting combat sports on the planet as the excitement continues here in round two. An aggressive start by the champion.
Go!
You know, it's interesting because...
Oh, left hand kick by Marcus!
Marcus has landed two really hard kicks so far in this round. And he kind of had a smirk on his face when he looked into the eyes of Levin. It's a thing where they stand here like gunslingers staring at each other, waiting for the guy to make a move.
Especially with Levin's propensity to want to counter, gets underneath that jab, and they clinch again.
Go.
See, this is something that Marcus did not do when he fought Schilling. He did not do when he fought the guy in China.
Nice. Kick by Levin, and they exchange there. Levin ducking underneath. Marcus attack, a knee to the middle. Left kick to the body by Marcus. Eats that punch from Levin. Now the action picking up here. Past the minute mark of the second round.
Marcus is doing everything right now.
Go.
He's pushing the action. He's forcing Levin to fight his fight.
Marcus grew up in Toronto, had issues as a teenager, expelled from school, spent time in a detention center, but walked into Siam number one gym, discovered Muay Thai, became one of the best in the world at the Science of Eight Limbs, and now is on the cusp of becoming Glory middleweight champion. But Levin will do everything in his power to make sure the championship stays right here in San Diego.
What I was saying earlier is that Marcus is more patient.
Straight right hand by Levin.
He's much more patient in this fight. And is paying dividends when he does explode.
Levin, you're holding.
Go.
Catches that kick. Oh, and then sweeps the other leg, which not legal. And the knee countered by Levin.
He got him mad, though. Simon Marcus got angry. Look, he's moving forward.
Left hook to the body by Marcus. And there's that clinch. Man, if this keeps up, they're going to know what brand of deodorant the other uses by the end of this fight. Jab by Levin.
I think that trip, it really got into Marcus's head, and I think he got a little angry.
You hold again, I'm going to take a point away. Quit holding.
Go!
That's the final warning from...
Get out of there!
Rosales
knees
against Artem Levin from holding.
Again, you have 5 seconds in the clinch. Marcus coming forward, gets tagged. Final 10 seconds of the second round. Marcus gets dropped.
Now it's got personal.
Not the most aesthetically pleasing fight, but they're getting down and dirty here in San Diego.
Keep pressing, it's going to get down.
Okay. Why
you
are here?
Fuck it. Okay.
Yeah.
You want to send something for me? You
check. Steven, a young lady who is a 9-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu champion, Gabby Garcia in the house, and like every other female involved in any facet of combat sports, has UFC bantamweight champion Ronda Rousey on her mind.
I don't
think she can make 135. She didn't look like it.
Levin, no more holding.
Can Chris Cyborg make 135 is the question on all MMA fans' minds. As right now we continue with this Glory middleweight championship bout.
In answer to your question, I thought that Simon Marcus won that last round.
So you have it
split
one apiece.
Yeah, but the first one was iffy. I took a shot.
Stop! Watch the hands coming in.
But in that second round, more concise strikes were landed.
Oh, stiff jab by Levin. Another counter jab by Marcus, and you wonder how much more of this clinch work is Rosales going to allow before maybe deducting a point and really making things interesting. And there it is. It's Levin initiating the clinch, the thing that he said he would avoid.
Yeah. There we go. Moral.
On cue, my man. On cue.
Quit holding. I've been telling you, stop holding. Ready? Time in. Go.
So there you have it. Hopefully this will change the dynamic of the fight, as a point has been deducted from the champion, Artem Levin. And I know I was mentioning it, Stephen, but you're the fight professor. Do you agree with the call?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, I do,
because
too.
It is a kickboxing
Stop
match.
Stop breaking! Back up!
It's a hard call to make, because they're both fighters, they're both warriors, and they both fought under Muay Thai rules. But this is not a Muay Thai fight. They have a certain amount of time you can spend in the clinch, then you must break. And if you initiate the clinch and don't do active action, then you're basically stalling the fight. And that's what we saw happen. The funny thing is, it's a huge psychological victory for Simon Marcus right now, because he knows I'm out kickboxing you, so you want to turn it back into a Muay Thai fight.
Right hand behind the guard by Marcus. Looking at total strikes dead even. With Levin having the higher connect rate, but a close encounter in more ways than one in this middleweight championship affair.
The left kick of Simon Marcus has been the biggest problem.
Levin, a southpaw stance.
Yeah. There's that left kick again.
Outside, a low kick by Marcus. Oh, jump knee by Levin. Under a minute remaining in the third.
Stop.
Simon Marcus can throw that left kick really hard without even switching. He just throws the kick. Watch, right there.
And it's caught by Levin, who just lunges forward and clinches.
Stop! Break clean.
Again, a reminder earlier in this round, we saw a point deducted by referee Marcos Rosales to the champion Levin for the clinch work, something, you know, he maligned in their first meeting. He called it a clinch fest. Well, there's a right uppercut by Marcus, and again, it's the champion initiating the clinch. This is a recording. The exchange inside low kicks. Final seconds of the third round. We're heading into the championship rounds here at Glory 21 San Diego.
Go, time.
That point deduction is going to be a huge factor down the stretch in this fight. Because if it's a close fight, that's going to make the difference. Marcus is starting to figure out the timing of Artem Levin right now. The interesting thing is that Artem Levin is initiating the clinch, but Simon Marcus is fighting the more authentic Muay Thai style when it comes to blasting strikes.
Marcus was knocked out in the extra round in the last man standing tournament at his glory debut by Joe Schilling, knocked out in China earlier this year, but so far his chin has not been tested by the champion Artem Levin.
Levin's style isn't a one-punch knockout guy.
Right.
Like Joe Schilling, he throws everything behind every punch. So if he hits you, he's probably gonna knock you out.
Championship rounds are upon us. Outside low kick by Levin. Mauro Ranallo, along with the fight professor, Stephen Quadros, Bill Goldberg, and the entire Glory crew on hand. Spinning back fist bounced off the deltoid region of Marcus.
The competitive spirit I'm seeing here when they just gunslinger each other like this, it's just amazing to me. I know people that want to see...
Oh, wow. Double kick there with the right leg.
Yeah, people that want to see just tough man contest style fighting, this is not the one. You're going to see high level of technique here.
Left hook over the top by Levin. It's a chess match. Each of them wanting to read each other's body language.
Break clean.
And there Levin at least went to the knees.
Go.
Immediately in the clinch. Oh, right hand, but there, right from Levin. The jab by Levin, and immediately goes to the clinch again.
Yeah, he could have
Step back.
Take a step back and throw the straight right or uppercut or something.
Ducks underneath the left hook by Marcus.
Let go, Levin. I said let go. Go.
Oh, nice. Right kick to the face by Marcus.
boy.
Right uppercut by Marcus.
Marcus doing everything right. It's almost like he can't miss right now.
Stop.
Then the clinch.
Go.
A minute and a half remaining in the fourth. Levin tries the front kick. Marcus, and you look at the stats, very close. Dead even in total kicks landed.
It's just the percentage rate.
Higher for the champion.
That's right. That's going to be big. But you know what?
Artem
just got caught with a good right hand right there.
Avoids that left head kick. Backs out of the way, and now they just look at each other. Oh, look at Levin. Some showmanship, putting his right glove behind his back, giving
Stop.
Marcus what appeared to be a free shot. Under a minute left in the
Go.
Fourth. Oh, left hand rattles the jaw of Marcus, but he walks right through it.
Stop. Break clean. Get off the ropes. Go.
The problem is this. Marcus
Stop. Break clean.
Could hurt Artem Levin, but right now I don't see how Artem Levin can hurt Marcus unless he catches him perfectly right on the chin with a left hook or an uppercut.
Levin faints. 20 seconds left. Both of them wanting the other to seek the initiative so they can counter. 15 seconds remaining in the round. Marcus catches it, and he does what Levin. That's called a receipt, my man. He did what Levin did earlier in the fight, and it's illegal, but the gamesmanship on full display.
To me, that's another round in the books for Simon Marcus. Marcus really burying his attack in that round, including this gem. Wait, it caught Artem Levin right on the jaw with that front kick. It was a good right hand by Artem Levin. Marcus shook it off and came raging in, missed the left hook, but landed that jab. Turned it into a brawl momentarily in the corner.
So how do you have it going into the fifth and final round?
Well, I've got Artem Levin maybe winning that first round, but the other rounds have been Simon Marcus plus the deduction. Artem Levin needs a knockout to win this fight, in my opinion.
Tia lets us know it is the fifth and final round. The bell goes. Artem Levin, the champion in the white gloves. The challenger, Simon Marcus, in the black gloves. Left kick to the body. Levin ducks underneath the sweeping left hook. There are the knees that you're supposed to do in the active clinch. You can't just clinch and sit there.
Stop, break clean, get out.
Artem Levin is gonna have to change up, do something drastic here. Land a back fist or a flying knee or something crazy, because he's not gonna win the fight by clinching and getting warned and not landing any good shots.
Canada's already home to two glory champions, featherweight kingpin Gabriel Varga, glory welterweight champion Joseph Valtellini. Simon Marcus, to use a hockey term, wants to make it a hat trick for the Canucks. Maybe on his way to doing so here tonight. But Levin, the veteran, what does he have left in his bag of tricks?
See, Marcus is pushing the pace. He's attacking more.
Stop! Break clean! Stop! Get out! Go!
There's the emotion again.
Oh! Another front kick to the face by Marcus, picking his spots, making it count, and now time becoming a factor.
Stop! Break
1 minute and 20 seconds left in the glory middleweight title fight.
Go!
Marcus is dictating everything here.
The champions hold on the gold in a precarious position. Marcus saying, come on, bring it.
Stop. Nothing.
We are headed into the final 60 seconds. Will there be last minute drama at the Valley View Casino Center in San Diego? Levin avoids the jab. Outside low kick by the challenger. spinning back fist misses by the champion.
Levin, let go.
Levin looking to the screen, looking at the clock.
Crazy thing to me, Moro, is that Marcus has out-kickboxed Levin.
Making the transition from Muay Thai, where he was one of the best ever. There's a 1-2 combination from Simon Marcus. 20 seconds left in the fight. Again, it's the champion initiating the clinch when he should be worrying about the uptick in his output. Marcus coming forward. 10 seconds left. Is a new champion about to be crowned in the glory middleweight division. The judges will render their verdict. How'd you have it, Fight Professor?
I've got Simon Marcus winning the fight. He pretty much won every round, in my opinion, except for the first. Artem Levin didn't deliver in the Roy Jones aspect of bombing from the outside with punches. I'm kind of surprised. But I think a lot of that had to do with Simon Marcus. Simon Marcus didn't let him.
What was the biggest, what impressed you the most from each athlete to give us a sense of what we're looking at going into the judges' scorecard?
Well, the thing is that Simon Marcus pressed the action. He didn't initiate any of the stalling, and Artem Levin did. Whereas Marcus, he landed the cleaner shots, especially with the body kick. His left kick was beautiful. Didn't land it a great deal, but enough, in my opinion. And here we have it. Punches landed, Artem Levin, but the kicks may be the equalizing factor, and the knees for sure. Artem initiated the clinch, yet Simon Marcus was the one who won the battle in the clinch with the knees. And when they come out, and it was a misspinning back fist into the clinch and the tie-up, it's like, you know, Simon Marcus.
Good highlights here from Levin.
Yeah, Levin is doing really well.
In that opening round,
that was the
opening,
exactly the one I thought that he won. But then he basically gave up on that. And I think it's because Simon Marcus came out with a lot more fury in that second round. He really pressed the action. And there we have the kick down by Levin, where we're going to see some cover. There, okay, here we have Artem Levin continuing. When they get in boxing range, to tie up Simon Marcus. And that became a no-no. When Simon Marcus started to outbox Levin, Levin went to the clinch, and the referee decided that's enough of that. I'm gonna take away a point. Simon Marcus continued to press the action. Remember that sweep takedown that we saw earlier? We're gonna see another one coming up here, where Simon Marcus is gonna initiate the sweep though. Nice front kick to the face. And that is an annoying thing, because we don't see too many knockouts here with a front kick to the face other than Anderson Silva and, of course, Lyoto Machida against Randy Couture. But here we are in the clinch. Marcus started to find his range with the knees in the clinch. And so Marcus pushed the action, pressed everything. Another front kick to the face. It wasn't a dominating performance by any stretch of the imagination, but I believe Simon Marcus did enough to win this fight.
All right, well, let's find out. Here's Tim Hughes.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 championship rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard.
Judge Louis Cobian scores the bout 48-46, Marcus. Judge Nelson Hamilton and Judge Cecil Peoples score the bout 47-47, a majority draw.
A majority draw means that Artem Levin will hold on to the glory middleweight championship.
Glory middleweight champion of the world, Artem Levin.
Wow.
Here we go. And Mr. Bill Goldberg.
Okay, Simon, what do you think about the decision?
Bullshit. Wow. I won that fight.
Okay, there you have it. Let's go find out what the champion has to say. Artem, what was the difference in that fight for you winning?
The champion is fuckery. That's the blood clot.
Hey, shout you a man.
Wow.
Right here, Artem, Artem.
Come in the ring with me if you want something.
What?
I want the big thank you from refereeing this fight for 1 point in third round. Thank you so much. Without his mistake, my belt here with my win.
Okay, there it is, one more time. Artem Levin, still your champion, but a very unhappy Simon Marcus. Back to you, Mauro.
Well, this decision will be debated on social media for a long time to come by the hair of his chinny chin chin. Artem the Lion Levin hangs on to the glory middleweight title via majority draw.
It was a close fight, but it was one of those things where it was just clinch fest again.
Well, an unsatisfying ending here after what was a terrific night of action at Glory 21. That shall be debated for a long time to come. And speaking of, the next time we will see you will be at Glory 22, Friday, June 5th in Lille, France. Thanks for watching Glory 21 San Diego. For the Fight Professor and Bill Globberg, I'm Mauro Ranallo. Good night.
Let's this fight go on. Can Francois Mbeng? Oh, what a shot!